expect to miss around 50% of questions. All right, GMAT myth number two, I need to get almost all of the questions right on test day to get a high score. I see this one a lot in my YouTube comments. I see a lot of people who are really concerned with accuracy, who are saying, I only get 75% of these questions right in practice. And they're really worked up about that. And I have to tell them that that's actually maybe not the biggest deal in the world. Do you hear this one a lot, Eric?
Yeah, absolutely. And it makes sense, you know, because of the way that we all tested growing up, right? Your teacher hands out a test to you, or, you know, everybody gets the same test on a, you know, on a computer, and it's the same exact questions. And therefore, in the end, it's how many you got right and how many you got wrong. And so, you know, makes sense. If you want to get a high score, you have to get the majority of the questions right. But again, as this is a computer adaptive test, right, it's built for you, right? So ultimately, everyone will get questions that are at some point will be consistently challenging for them. So even people like Erica, right, who scores super high on the test, at some point, we're going to hopefully get up to where we can start to pin her a little bit, and we'll start to try to give her questions that maybe are a little bit higher, a little bit stronger than even she can handle. I can't imagine there's a whole lot of those, but the point is, even somebody who gets an 800 still gets questions wrong.
Absolutely. And I can confirm that on my test day, there were some questions that were really hard. And, you know, even if they were something that I maybe could have answered if I was sitting down at my desk, relaxed with a little snack, on test day, they were really hard and it just wasn't occurring to me. And I had to guess and move on. 99th percentile score, you're still going to be hitting those harder questions. So this seems like a good time to go through the algorithm and what makes this test so different.
Yeah, that'd be great. This is, we sort of look at first question to last question. And if you think about easy to hard questions and how they're scored, right, that those would be comparable, right? Maybe it makes sense. So the harder the question, the higher the score. You know, in this situation, mainly what this is what we do with every candidate, right? So we serve up a middle tier question to everyone. So that's what that little white dot is over there. And so let's just say that you're nervous, which makes perfect sense. A lot of people are going to, you know, they feel comfortable when they're at home, but now all of a sudden they're in a test center and they've had to check in. They just want to sort of get into their groove, but they're probably not quite into it until they get into a few questions. You might get this question wrong, even though you normally would have gotten this question right. So we're going to then serve up another question to you that's going to be a little bit easier. Now, again, you may still be nervous. You may even get that question wrong, or you may get it right. Here, you got it wrong. And then finally, we get you to a question where you're going to get the one right. And so now we're going to give you a harder question. And then you're going to start to move up. And that little white dot would have normally been moving up and down here, you know, to kind of show you that you're getting a harder and harder question. And then we continue. And we're ultimately going to get up to a level where you're going to start getting a question right, get a question wrong. And we're going to continue that until the very end. So we continue to try to figure out exactly where you are. So if you can kind of see this pattern, again, you started out at a medium level, you got some questions wrong, you normally would have gotten right. You finally get down to something that, you know, maybe helps you just calm down a little bit. And then you're going to move up to your level. And then maybe you're maybe a little higher than your level, then a little lower. And then you're going to continue to try to pin you. And so what we give to the schools though, and what we give to you is that upper bracket, right? So it's really which questions that you consistently answer correctly that's going to impact your score. So again, it's not how many questions you got right and how many you got wrong. It's really about which questions you got right on a consistent basis.
So I have a question for you, Eric, just to kind of confirm that what I'm sharing with my students is accurate. Your score is a reflection of the difficulty where you're getting about half of them right and half of them wrong. So students should expect that if they're performing at their level, which is their score level on test day, they should expect to miss around 50% of questions. Would you say that's accurate?
Absolutely. And that can be kind of the challenge. It's where you need to kind of stay within yourself. Because again, it's not positive reinforcing, you know, to have that kind of experience. So I always tell people that, you know, at some point you're going to start to feel like every question it's challenging, but doable. And you may actually feel like it's a little bit more challenging than doable, but the point is we're trying to get it up to where it's again, at your level. And again, everyone's going to have the same feeling kind of at the end, but where they actually are feeling that are very different. So what Erica tests at is going to be a very different level than where I test at, which would probably be very, very low.
Well, thank you. This is super helpful. Yeah, I think that this is a tough pill to swallow for a lot of my students, especially students who are perfectionists, maybe students who have tested well in the past and for whom this structure is challenging, especially because they can't skip questions. Where I really struggled with that concept of not being able to skip a question, right? Because I'd be sitting there going, I don't want to miss this. And I think if I came back to it, I could do it. And just that, for me, that knowledge that I can miss half of the questions, as long as I'm getting roughly at my level, was so freeing.
Absolutely. And certainly, you know, guess when appropriate, right? That's part of what's going on here. I mean, if it makes you feel any better, this allows for a shorter test. It's still at an exceptionally high level of reliability in what those scores mean and how valid they are in predicting your academic success within, you know, business schools, right? So if we're trying to get an accurate score, right? So you want an accurate score, the schools you're applying to want an accurate score, and all the subscores and so forth. We have to give you appropriate level questions. Well, if you were just taking it on paper, we'd have to give you a bunch of really easy ones. We'd have to give you a bunch of really hard ones. We'd have to give you a bunch in the middle because we don't know where you are. But this allows us to more quickly get there. And therefore you have hopefully a better testing experience. It makes it more accurate. It also makes it more secure. I mean, there's lots of benefits, you know, to this. So yeah.